The beast was too strong. His animal savagery nearly cost me my life. I took my frustrations out on a lone patient. His case notes suggested he was a paranoid schizophrenic. His pleas, as I beat him to death, suggested much more. His confessions were illuminating. My path was clear.
Ivy's getting stronger. I need to stop her now.
I think she's still in the gardens where you left her, but she'll be in control of it now. You'll be walking into a trap.
That's what she thinks.
This island belongs to me now. What do you think you can do, Batman? I am everywhere. My babies know your every move. You and your kind are arrogant enough to think you can destroy us. You will fail, and we will become the most powerful force on the planet.
Is the generosity of our benefactors on the wane?
Taped interview 39. Patient's name is Edward Nigma. At this point in time, I've yet to decide if Mr. Nigma is a suitable candidate for the Titan process. I'd like to talk about your childhood.
Miserable. Next.
By all accounts, that is where your fascination with riddles began. I believe discussing those years could explain your compulsive behavior.
Very well. My father hated me. Always called me a moron.
I see.
I was determined to prove him wrong, so I entered a contest at school. A $20 prize to the kid who could figure out an almost impossible logic problem. I won, of course.
And that pleased your father?
Hardly. He was convinced I had cheated. He kept yelling, "You must have cheated! Admit it, you moron! You cheated!" I swore I didn't. And he hit me for lying.
I'm sorry to hear that, Edward.
Don't be. He was right.
Do you like riddles, Batman?
Every day I found the patients more distracting. Their insane mutterings and constant twitching disgusted me. There was only one way to cure this evil. Only one way to purify the city and ensure its future. I needed to prepare myself. I needed to be ready. I had a sudden pang of conscience. I sought counsel from my priest on the choices I had made. I asked him if it was a sin to kill in order to save a life. The holy man said all life was sacred, but a judgment would not be upon my soul if I acted to save another. I left the confessional with my soul uplifted, convinced more than ever, I am doing a service not only to mankind, but to God as well.
not. You found 75% of my challenges? This can't be right.
Interview 44. This is yet another interview with Edward Nigma. I have yet to make up my mind whether he's a genius or just deluded. Whichever one he is, just being in his company is both irritating and exhausting.
Hello, Miss Young. You look tired. Anything you need my help with?
No, thank you, Edward. I am here to help you. We all are.
Forgive my arrogance, Doctor, but if you think I need your help, well, you're in the right place.
Let's look at it a different way. Throughout your career, you have specialized in bizarre traps and convoluted clues that more often than not result in the death of the unfortunate participants.
And if the citizens of Gotham were smarter, my games would be merely an amusing diversion.
Instead of death traps.
You really should be thanking me. Weeding out the ignorant, the stupid, the useless. But don't worry. I'm sure you would survive. What a lovely photo on your desk, Doctor. Your family? Mother, perhaps.
Put that down! Get out! Guard!
Thank you.
expose him.
You know who he is?
More important, I know what he is.
What do you mean?
It's obvious. The mask, the weapons, the scare tactics. He's a criminal. No different than Joker, Two-Face, or myself.
Most people consider him a hero.
Most people are idiots. They can't see Batman for the villain he is. Riddle me this. How did he get his car and his gadgets?
I don't...
With money stolen from the criminals he defeats. Why does Gordon turn a blind eye to his antics? Batman bribes him. The answers are right in front of your stupid, gawking face.
Edward, please, calm down.